Chicago, Vegas, Houston, Miami. MadeToCreate.me.
Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Koss from MadeToCreate.me, your premier mixing and mastering service. And today we are going to be taking a look at some of the effects that were used in Kanye West's new song, Wolves. So I'm just going to play back the track right now and let you guys have a quick listen through and see if you like it. And if you do, I'd love for you to spend the next couple minutes with me.
If mama knew how you turn out, you're too wild, you're too wild, you're too wild, you're too wild. I need you now. Got to love you. Love you.
Alright guys, so that's the song. As always, if you want to purchase FL Studio, check the link in the description box below or enter the code popping up on screen right now at checkout on imageline.com for a 10% discount. Also, if you use the code, you'd be supporting my channel and any future tutorials. But without talking too much, let's get into the tutorial. As always, I try to get as close to the sound as possible. I know it's not 100% perfect, but it should give you a good idea of some of the effects and techniques that were actually used in the song. Alright, so let's start off with the instrumental, and then I'll take you through the vocals. So I'm just going to mute the vocals for now, so we can listen to just the instrumental. And as you'll be able to tell right away, the instrumental was actually fairly easy to make, but it's still a very powerful piece of music, so good on Kanye West for doing it that way. So the first thing that I did was create the kick. And that's a really simple kick pattern. So it's always happening on the first and the third beat, and that's pretty much it. And for some of the parts, like over here, the kick actually drops out. So basically all you want to do is just drag it out, and then that way that one kick sample that happens here won't play. And then I took the kick and I routed it over to my mixer and just threw an EQ on it just to boost the bass a little bit and to drown out the higher frequencies a little bit, just to match it a little bit closer to the kick sample that Kanye was actually using. So after the kick, I created the bass over here. And for the bass sound, I'm using GMS. And GMS is basically a synthesizer that comes with FL Studio. And this is just a preset, and the bass is called Aggressive. And that too is routed over to the mixer track number 10 in my bass track over here. To make it sound a little bit more boomy, I added a couple effects, because this is what it sounded like before the effects. So you definitely want it to stand out a little bit more. So what I basically did was add a fruity wave shaper, and just hit right click over here and preset fast distortion 2. That'll give it that cool distortion sound. And over here on this slider, I turned it down to about half, which means that half the signal is going to be processed with that distortion sound, and half the signal is basically going to be left untouched. Then I added a fruity parametric EQ just to basically roll off some of the higher end on the bass. And then after that, I used the fruity limiter as a compressor to sidechain my kick to the bass. And basically what that's doing, for those of you who aren't familiar with sidechain compression, is that basically every time the kick's playing, the bass gets attenuated a little bit, so the volume goes down on the bass so that the overall volume doesn't start peaking out, because you have two like really loud low frequencies playing at once. So it's a very common thing to do, and in order to do that in FL Studio, basically you just want to click on your kick channel down here, click on this little arrow, and then on your bass channel, you add the fruity limiter, you go over to the compression function, adjust the threshold, the knee, and the ratio. And then in the sidechain section, you want to right click and select kick. And then you'll see that whenever the kick's playing, the bass gets ducked down a little bit. And And with the threshold, you're basically dictating how much you want the bass to get pushed down. So when you're adjusting that, you want to look at your channel meter over here and try to make it so that the meter stays as even as possible whenever the kick's playing. Now, if I put the threshold all the way up, you'll see that the meter every time when the kick's playing is going to jump up. So you want to try to get it to that sweet spot where the meter doesn't really jump up or down. And oh yeah, before I forget it, I also automated the EQ to make the bass sound a little bit more interesting. So just check this out for a minute. So that almost gives it a little bit of that dubsteppy feel, and that was another reason for the EQ. So with that automation clip, I'm basically automating the low pass filter. So in order to do that, all you have to do is right click on the knob here and hit create automation clip. And that will come up with a clip that looks like this. And then you can start creating like these little knobbies everywhere. And that will basically tell the filter how, like what frequency it should start filtering out. And yeah, over here I just created a bunch of them and kind of did them in a little bit of a random order just to make the bass a little bit more interesting, so it sounds kind of cool. The next thing I worked on was a snare, which is also fairly simple. And the way I created the snare is just basically I used the snare sample that was already available to me and open my piano roll, so right click and just piano roll over here on the snare, and then you can start filling in your little notes over here. And the only reason I use the piano roll instead of the channel rack over here is just because the channel rack only allows me to do quarter notes, while the piano roll allows me to do up to 64th notes, if I'm not mistaken. So much smaller segments if I wanted to. And these snare hits are basically matched to the original track. So I listened to the original track over and over again and figured out where the snare hits were, and I adjusted them. Another cool thing what you can do in the piano roll is when you have those little rolls happening, like right over here, you can actually adjust the gain for the sample just to make it sound a little bit more natural. So anytime you're doing like a snare roll or anything like that, basically what you want to do is just right click down here just to make that first hit a little bit quieter than the hits that are happening after that. And yeah, that way it'll sound more natural and just a lot better than if it's all the same volume down here. Also, when you're working with hi-hats, the gain or velocity automation is a technique that's used fairly often just to make it sound a little bit more dynamic and interesting. So once I had that, I routed my snare through to mixer channel number 12. I just added a fruity limiter. So the limiter is basically used as a compressor again. So over here, you just want to go into your compressor section, adjust the threshold, like really push it down. And the ratio, I have mine set to like 7.5. So it's a pretty crazy ratio, and the knee pretty high as well. I always find the more you compress a sound, the less dynamic it's going to get, but the more punch you're going to get out of something. So you'll end up with a lot more body to the sound as opposed to that first like transient. So if you want a really fat sound, you really want to kick the compression in there. And then once you're done with that, just adjust the makeup gain to make it sound a little bit louder again. Then I added the parametric EQ, again, just to make it sound a little bit closer to the original sound. I know it looks a little bit funky right now, but in the end, it did kind of make it work. And then just the reverb to match it a little bit more to the original sound as well. And the reverb is just a preset as well. So see, you can find those by just looking through, clicking through these arrows here, or right clicking, and it'll give you a couple of presets. And then what you want to do is just once you've found something that sounds pretty decent, you want to just turn down the wet a little bit, turn down the early reflections, just because I find they sound a little bit weird on the reverb and you don't really need them anyways. And then that's basically the sound that you're left with. The next thing was the cymbals. If you listen to the original track, you'll find that there was some weird cymbal noise going on in the background, and that's that sound here. And that sounds basically just a cymbal sample that I had. And that's what it sounded like originally. Routed it through to the mixer again, added a parametric EQ to roll off the high end a little bit. The wave shaper to get that distortion thing going again. So right click, fast distortion 2. Parametric EQ again, just to roll off the high end again, because I found there was still a little bit too much high end in there. The reverb to give it that large spacey sound again. And then my new all-time favorite free plugin is the saturation knob from SoftTube. For this, I'll actually leave a link in the description below again so you guys can download that. It's a free plugin, it's great. I use it on vocals a lot, as you'll see in a minute. And it's such a simple plugin. You just basically turn up the saturation knob over here and you can choose what type of saturation you want. If you want the higher frequencies being saturated, the lower frequencies, or just like a general neutral sort of frequency saturation. And yeah, it'll give you really nice fat sounds. So that simple saturation knob makes a pretty big difference over in that sound. The last thing I added for this sound was over here, the piano. And for the piano, I didn't work with stock plugins. I used a plugin called Addictive Keys. And Addictive Keys, it's fairly expensive, but it's an amazing plugin to use for realistic piano sounds. So for this specific sound, I think I used the Studio Grand and H strings over here. So if you want to check that plugin out, I'll leave a link in the description below again. But if you don't want to spend the money, you can also use FL's built-in plugins, which are sort of okay. There is FL Keys that you can use, or you can use Citrus that also has some pretty cool piano sounds going on. So let me just copy those notes over into the FL Keys over here. Mute that, send that to the same mixer channel. So that's FL Keys compared to Addictive Keys. And I just find Addictive Keys just sounds a lot more realistic. Now, I bet if you put more time into FL Keys to adjust all the parameters that are available in that synthesizer, you could probably make it sound really good. But I'm on a Mac and I'm still using the FL Studio 12 Alpha. And there's just, it's just so messed up. Like all my knobs are missing and everything. It's just so weird, but anyways, I make it work, right? So basically all I did after that was routed the Addictive Keys through to mixer channel number 13. And on that, I just basically have a delay. And if you right click on the time setting over here, you can click on set and two steps. And that'll give you the exact timing that you want to use. I just turned up the feedback volume a little bit as well, just to make that delay sustained a little bit longer. Because in the original position, it just kind of drowns out really quickly. And basically this feedback control is telling it that, you know, you want it to feedback a little bit longer. Because in the original song, there was a long sort of delay happening. And that's pretty much it for the instrumental. Like I said, pretty simple. So let's move on over to the vocals again. And I think this is where it gets a little bit more complicated, but I really love it, man. Like, I listen to the sound. And one thing about Kanye West, he never really steps back from, like, you know, a sort of different sound, different effect, which makes it really interesting for me to actually do a tutorial on, because it's not just the regular plain old whatever, what have you, like a reverb or a compressor or whatever. He used some pretty interesting effects on his vocals and it made it sound pretty cool.
If mama knew how you turn out, you're too wild, you're too wild, you're too wild, you're too wild. I need you now. Got to love you. Love you. Found you, found you. Love it right now, right now, right now. I need you now.